Try out new courses of action, and interact authentically with others whose beliefs or choices sometimes challenge your own. You have become strategic thinkers who can navigate your challenges and strong leaders who will make a difference in your communities and the world. We are extremely proud of you. Always remember, who you are is what makes you special. Do not change for anyone. What lies ahead will always be a mystery, so do not be afraid to explore. And where there are choices to make, make the one you won't regret. Class of 2016, you give us hope that through your forward-thinking, intuitive, and responsible leadership, a real, true difference can be made that will make the world a better place for us all. I hope your dreams take you to the corners of your smiles, to the highest of your hopes, to the windows of your opportunities, and to the most special places your heart has ever known. We are proud of your achievements and congratulate you for a job well done. Thank you.
The class of 2016 are the most resilient class ever. school has ever encountered. We are the change. Our class is full of the brightest, wittiest, and most determined young women in Rangel's history. There is not a problem we cannot solve when we put our minds on it. What class was able to prepare a successful prank in the span of a few hours? What class has not only the most diverse set of peers, but the strongest sisterly bond? What class was the first to participate in an internship program provided by our school? And what class has earned over $9.7 million in academic and merit scholarships and has been accepted in over 110 different colleges and universities across the nation? Our class, the class of 2016. Because of our hard work, we have been able to achieve all of these accomplishments. Of course, we have had a lot of help along the way. We owe great thanks to all our amazing teachers and staff, counselors, advisors, mentors, sponsors, and especially to our supportive parents and guardians. We also owe special thanks to Lee and Sally Posey, who helped establish our magnificent school. We wouldn't be here without the support and guidance from all the people mentioned above. So thank you. Class of 2016, I have seen each and every one of you grow into magnificent young ladies. But just because we're a pretty amazing set of gals doesn't mean we are perfect. In fact, I know that we are worried about our future, worried about what is to come and the challenges that are to be faced. Unfortunately, I can guarantee you that there are going to be many obstacles along our intricate path towards adulthood. But I can also assure you that each and every one of us is capable of overcoming any adversities thrown at us. We are big dreamers and big achievers. As Eleanor Roosevelt once said, the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. So class of 2016, I challenge you to dream on and never give up in the face of defeat. Dream and achieve all of your passions. Who knows? We could have the future president of the United States right in this room, here with us today. Or maybe the next Beyonce or Jennifer Lawrence. Perhaps the next Maya Angelou or Marie Curie. We could have a room full of doctors, engineers, authors, lawyers, photographers, dancers, or astronauts. These are all possibilities for our future. But you know what we definitely have in this room? World changers. Class of 2016, live on and be the best that you can be. Congratulations on your high school career. And remember to always believe in the beauty of your dreams because we are going to change the world.
Once again, we
Good afternoon, honored guests, family members, and friends of the class of 2016. It is a great privilege to stand before you today, sharing not a speech, but a story. The story of a wonderful sisterhood that brought us to the magnificent place where we are. Because today is not about me, it's about us. It's our story, which we have written with laughter, mistakes, love, and most importantly, experience. And we will continue to write this story because life goes on. Really, graduation is just the completion of a book in the series that is our lives. And if there is anything that I have learned in my 7 years at Rangel, is that there is a happy ending to all the stress, frustration, and drama in this story that we have created. For now, let's call it the formula for success. I mean, look at us. Got it this far, right? So this is what I really want you to remember, my sisters. If you follow the formula, then there's a good chance that nothing can go wrong. Just like writing an essay, there are several steps to being successful. But unlike writing an essay, you don't necessarily have to be followed in order. So do what feels right for you and your belief. So for us that need order, and can't remember stuff very well. That's me, and you too, sis. I've created an acronym for us. And it's called SWAG. S-W-A-G. Awesome, right? But if that doesn't fill your boat, then you can sag, or wag, or even saw. But it's up to you, as long as you don't forget what these letters actually represent. SWAG, SWAG. Seriously though, S stands for sincerity. In life, you have to be sincere, not only with others, but with yourself. Only you know where your passion lies, yours, not anyone else's. Which is why when I say sincere, I mean be yourself. Love who you are and what you like. Do not approach life trying to please others, much less letting them live out their dreams through you. Trust me, it is extremely hard to want everyone to like you or to approve of what you do. And frankly, it is impossible because there will always be someone who is displeased. So rather than focus on things that you cannot control, be determined to live happily by satisfying your wants and needs. Be sincere to yourself. And so to do so, you need to work. Yeah. As the W, work hard, work efficiently, work for your future. Like I said before, be sincere with what you want and put your best efforts to achieve it. You get in what you put in, as Ms. Tatum would say. So be sure to work hard to reach all of your goals. Just look at all of the achievements we've accomplished as a class. There's proof that we know what we're doing, or at least we definitely know how to work hard. And in that case, just continue to do so, and you'll be good. And now, let's get acquainted with the amazingly awesome, advantageous word that is adulthood. We're all adults now. Sorry, Celine, Annabelle, anyone else that isn't 18 yet. You've kind of been expedited into adulthood by graduating. Kind of like express shipping. But you know, it is what it is. That's life. But with adulthood comes responsibility. I realize there is so much to do and see in life. And becoming an adult gives a person unimaginable freedom and power. But remember, as adults, we have to make sure we stay level-headed. Yes, I'm sure there is action and adventure on our journey as well. But just make sure that you never forget that there is a consequence for everything, good or bad. And as adults, the prices we pay for bad consequences are much higher than they were in the past. The decisions we make today will impact our tomorrow, and we must be ready for them. Adulthood should be taken seriously. Like my sister mentioned, we are the future of the world, and it's a job we should be grateful and willing to do. Thus, we must show generosity to all of those who we encounter, and especially to those people who lent us a helping hand. We must lend our services and help others. Be generous with your time when volunteering. Give back to your community to ensure that others can live a happier life. Trust me, it will make you happier in the process as well. Thank all of your teachers, mentors, counselors, friends, and especially your parents and guardians. I know I am wholly indebted to my parents and teachers for providing support throughout my high school career and my entire life. Thank these people, and be sure to express your appreciation as often as possible, because though I am advising you to be generous and kind, not everyone in the world will be. Thus, you must be the change and show the world that good manners are not extinct yet. Sincerity, work, adulthood, and generosity. Swag. To the class of 2016, we did it. Not to be arrogant or anything, but they will never forget us. We've done too much. We've beat their expectations, and we will continue to write our own future. And now, we've got swag.
Representing District 9, Bernadette Nuttall was elected to the Dallas Independent School District Board of Trustees in December 2009. Ms. Nuttall earned a Bachelor of Art in Business Management from Sam Houston State University in Huntsville. She received a Certificate of Competence Training in Instructional Leadership from the University of North Texas in Denton. Ms. Nuttall is an active member in her community and in 1999 co-founded Circle of Support Incorporated, a comprehensive academic and enrichment summer learning program for students in kindergarten through eighth grade. The program provides summer educational programs for more than 250 boys and girls in math, science, art, and reading. Ms. Nuttall is married and has two daughters.
I'm glad to be with the class of 2016 with all your swag. 2016, Irma Rangel graduates. All the places you go and all the places you are going. I'm happy and proud to be with you on your special day, graduation day. It is graduation day and things are coming to an end and the start of new beginnings begin. You are on your way up. You're going to see great heights. You join the high flyers. You soar to high heights. Irma Rangel. You're on your own. You know what you know. And you are the girl who will decide where to go. What are your plans, ladies? College, a job, some hard work with your hands? A degree, a job, or some hard work with your hands is important. That much is clear, but that's not the only thing you need to know, my dear. Walk with pride with your graduation hat and tell the world you did that by posting it on Snapchat. But you must remember your ABCs. No, not the alphabet, reading and writing, but these are the ABCs for the keys to life. The first is attitude. For attitude, that's an important quality that a person can alter her life simply by altering her attitude. B is for always, ladies, believing in yourself. You're the one who has the last word of whether you succeed or fail. And C is for your character. Someone once said that character is who you are when no one is looking. Now it's up to you, ladies, to shape who you are and who you will become through the decisions you make when no one is looking, not your teachers or parents. It's up to you to seek the high road always of honesty, integrity, fairness, and compassion towards others. And your last, don't forget, ladies, D is for determination. Success is to be measured not so much by the position that one has reached in life as by the obstacles what she has had to overcome while trying to succeed. Today, lady, anything seems possible, but there will be days ahead when nothing seems possible. On those days, ladies, you must reach deep inside and find determination to please continue on. You must reach deep within and find courage to always fight for your dreams and fight for what you know you can be, and I believe you will be. Don't give up, give out, or ever get in, give in, ladies. Pull determination out and keep always pushing forward. People who get things done never give up. When they fail, they observe, learn, and get up. They make adjustments, not excuses. There's more about life, ladies, that you learn as you go. Because you know what? Figuring things out on your own will always help you grow. My message to you is, today is your day. You're off to great places. You're off and away. And you know what? You will succeed. Yes, you will indeed. 98.34% guaranteed. Irma Rangel graduates, girls, you move mountains. The world is waiting. So get on your way and start your swag.
As principal of Irma Lerma Rangel Young Women's Leadership School, I proudly present this year's candidates for graduation. Candidates, please stand. I hereby affirm that each candidate has met all the requirements for graduation as determined by the state of Texas and the Dallas Independent School District, and they are qualified to receive their diplomas, or they are otherwise qualified to participate in this graduation ceremony consistent with the laws of the state of Texas and the Dallas Independent School District.
As Chief of Human Capital Management of the Dallas Independent School District, I am pleased and honored to confirm the certification of the 2016 graduating class of Irma Lerma Rangel Young Women's Leadership Academy School. Excuse me.
Ladies, you may be seated. I would like to introduce the platform, and these are the persons, our distinguished guests, who will be shaking the hands and standing with the graduates when they're awarded their diplomas. So you've already been introduced to Bernadette Nuttall, School Board Trustee for Dallas and District 9. So Bernadette Nuttall, can you stand? Karen Chapman, the Chief of Human Capital Management. Adrian Luna, Executive Director for the Wilma Hutchins Theater Pack, Division 4. Tara Brown, Assistant Principal, Rangel. Arquette Baptiste, Senior Sponsor. Ann Romano, College Bound Advisor. And Natalie Thomas, High School Counselor. At this time, we will prepare for the presentation of diplomas. Members of the dais, please stand. Thank you. Maria Mendoza, highest honors. Rosa Maria Mendoza, highest honors. Cynthia Abigail Casiano, high honor. Angela Ulisa Chavez, honor. Thank you.
Carla Adriana Chavez. Julissa Crowder. Daisy Flores, high honors. Denise Garcia Valderas, high honors. Danielle Williams. Karen Guadalupe Gonzalez, high honors.
Thank you.
Marcus, honors.
Yeah.
Natalia Mata, highest honors.
Lynn T.
Lidia Marisol Reyes, honored.
Oh!
Capella. High honors.
This fall, the class of 2016-2020 will matriculate to 36 different colleges and universities across 11 states and Washington, D.C.
You are amazingly brilliant, and in a profound way, you uplift those around you to extraordinary heights. I hope that others can see your fierce passion, optimism, and zeal. If not, simply remind yourself that you are a conquering warrior with a compassionate spirit. Note that your outgoing enthusiasm is inspirational, and if you are courageous, you will be seen as the adventurous, beautiful, and magnificent person you truly are. Your creativity and imagination pair well with your constructive and strong humanism. You know that as a woman, you have to be twice as good, twice as fast, and twice as committed in order to get things done. I have faith in your dreams, and I know that your independence will help you lead others in grand endeavors. As you accept others, know that not everyone is as sociable as you are, and your gregarious nature might scare them off, but that's okay. You are equipped with an astonishing amount of resilience. So even a setback that isn't of an academic nature won't trip you up. Be steady, be fearless, be serendipitous, and you will always be who you really are, a graduate of the awesome Irma Lerma Rangel Young Women's Leadership School, class of 2016.
Please remain standing for the singing of our school hymn. I believe in